in a WhatsApp group that to make one different WhatsApp group for my batch, that is F1 batch, from 1 to 45. So can you, anyone can take the initiative to create the group using my number from 1 to 45? So then I will give the my class links and if any note in that group. So who will take the initiative to for creating the group? Starting from roll number 1 to roll number 45. Pranoy Gupta, will you take the initiative? Pranoy? Okay, then create the group after this class. Create the group starting from roll number 1 to 45 for IT batch F1. Okay, so you will then your problem will be solved and everything related to my class will be posted there. Okay, students. Still only 16 attendance. It is 11. And I want to give you one information that after my class, I will send one Google form. So create the group first and then I will send the Google form and it will just send your attendance, daily attendance there. Every day after my class, you will all send your class attendance. So after my class, prepare the WhatsApp group for my batch and there I will send the attendance form. You will fill up the attendance. Do you all know about the syllabus of your PH 101 syllabus? from my next class join timely, okay? Because if I share the screen, then after that you will not be admitted. Okay, students, now starting my class. All of you have a 45 total attendance is showing. Now 46, so all of you are here. So am I audible, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, in total physics syllabus, PH101 syllabus, how is it possible total 47 attendance? I told you all to join up to 1 to 45 and with me it will be 46. So how it is 47? I don't know. Now it is again 46. So just listen, you all, that roll number 1 to 45 is for me and 46 onwards, it is for Joyce ma'am. She will take the class for batch F2. At the same time, the classes will continue for F1 batch for me and for F2 batch for J. Maji ma'am. So join to your corresponding teacher. And if you create one separate WhatsApp group, then there I will post all my notes or questions or anything, any information I will post only for 1 to 45. So I requested Pranoy to create one WhatsApp group after this class, and where I will also send the class attendance in Google form and you will submit the form. So all of you are here, I know. So you will send the attendance in Google form after my class. I will send that Google link to that group, new group created for my F1 batch. Understand, all of you?
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, in physics, total, am I visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So, I am your teacher for PH101 syllabus, physics 1. So, this is your starting of your class, first year class, online class. So wishes you best wishes from my side for this semester. So concentrate in your study and whatever I am teaching, go through it. And it is the everyday follow, that is what I am just teaching you today. Just after the class, whenever you have time, just go through it. And don't delay it, because it will create problem for you all. So from the starting date, from my first class and your first class, be very careful, and it will help you a lot at the end of the semester.
Ma'am, one question.
Yes, ask.
Ma'am, where is the Google form?
What I said, that after my class, I requested Pranoy to create one separate WhatsApp group where containing roll number 1 to 45. There I will post the Google form. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Understand? So create one WhatsApp group. You have all the phone numbers there. So from 1 to 45, create the group. There I will post my attendance. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And create the group today, so that I can send you the Google form for class attendance. And I think you are all here because 46 attendance is showing in my class, including me, 45 students and one, and including me, teacher, one teacher, so 46. So no problem, you are all here, but I have to take your declaration that you are here in class. So fill the form, and also your email is there in Google form. Your roll number, you have to write your name, your email address. So there, so fill up, just fill it up very carefully and send it to me. Now I am sharing the screen. Actually, in your syllabus total, mechanics is there. Then for starting with mechanics, then it is optics. Then after that, electromagnetic theory is there. Then after that, statistical mechanics and quantum mechanics. Actually, again, 47 students are here. I don't know how it is. So some problem is here. So just make sure while creating the group that 1 to 45 roll number students are only here. So just I want to call your roll number again. So what is roll number 1?
Yes, ma'am.
What is your name?
Kunal Kesh.
Huh?
Kunal Kesh.
Kunal Kesh. Okay. Kunal Kesh. Then roll number 2?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Shomo Banerjee.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Roll number 3?
Present, ma'am.
What is your name? Where are you?
Ma'am, Abhijit Shaw. Ma'am, it's serial number 1 and roll number 3.
I want to know your roll number.
Serial number 1 and roll number 3.
Present, ma'am.
I just want to know your roll number.
Oh.
I'm just calling you by your roll number, not your serial number. Your class roll number, you know, all of you, do you know your roll numbers?
Ma'am, it is 2002003. Ma'am, my Abhijit Shah.
Actually, the last digit, tell me the last digit, na?
Ma'am, Abhijit Shah, ma'am, my is 3.
I want to know, I have given the information that 1 to roll number 45 is in this group. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So 1 is, where is that digit? The last digit, na, of your roll number?
Yes, ma'am, ma'am, my is 3, ma'am. Ma'am.
Achha, Adrita Pathak, roll number 3?
No, ma'am, I'm roll number 4.
Adrita is 4?
Yes, ma'am.
Then I am not calling my name, it will take time. So just telling you the roll number and just give your presence. Roll number 4, roll number 3, absent or present?
Ma'am, Abhijit Shah, present.
Okay. Roll number 4?
Present, ma'am.
5?
Present, ma'am.
6?
Present, ma'am.
7?
Present, ma'am.
8?
Present, ma'am.
9?
Present, ma'am.
10?
Present, ma'am.
11?
Present, ma'am.
12?
Present, ma'am.
13?
Present, ma'am.
14?
Present, ma'am.
15?
Present, ma'am.
16?
Present, ma'am.
17?
Present, ma'am.
18? Roll number 18? Visible? Is it visible? Screen sharing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So starting from simple harmonic motion, it is included in mechanics. Now your subject name is physics 1 and subject code, it is your that is it is BSPH 101. It is written here actually BSPH 201. The syllabus is same for your semester. It will be BSPH 101 and it is included in your module 1. And my name is Dr. Ranjita Sinha. I am assistant professor in the Department of Basic Science and Humanities. Actually, it is physics section in Asansol Engineering College. Now, the introduction to simple harmonic motion. So you all know that a motion that repeats itself in equal interval of time is called periodic motion. So all these things you all know from 12 and 11, that what is periodic motion? A motion that repeats itself in equal interval of time is called periodic motion. And when a particle in periodic motion moves to and fro along the same path, the motion is called oscillatory or vibratory motion. So the examples, that is the oscillation of simple pendulum. Simple pendulum executes simple harmonic motion. Oscillation of mass attached to a spring, that is mass spring system. That is again the example of simple harmonic motion. Any oscillatory motion should be periodic, but a periodic motion may not be always oscillatory. The time period. Next, I'm coming to time period. So these are very basic things. Before I start simple harmonic motion, you have to know all these things. And I just, this is the repetition. You all know, I think, that is the time period. So the time required to complete one oscillation, that is the time period definition. So the time required to complete one oscillation, this is the definition of time period. And what is the frequency? That is the number of oscillations made per second. So the relation between time period and frequency, it is given by n equal to 1 by t. So n is the frequency and t is the time period. Now, what do you mean by equilibrium or mean position? The position at which no net force acts on an oscillatory particle. So this is the equilibrium position or mean position. Now there are two things a displacement and amplitude. The distance of a particle at any instant from the equilibrium position, that is the displacement. Here displacement time graph is shown. Along the x-axis, that is time, is plotted, and along the y-axis, displacement is plotted. Now, the distance of a particle at an instant from the equilibrium position, say from here, this is the displacement. Y-axis, it is denotes the displacement. So if the particle, so this is the graph, this is the nature of the graph, it is drawn like this. Now it is t by 2 and here it is t. So one complete oscillation, the time period, this is from here to here. And amplitude is what? Maximum displacement on either side of the equilibrium position. So if I take this equilibrium position, so maximum displacement on either side of the equilibrium position. So here it is displacement A1 and here it is A2. In this way, the amplitude is here. So the maximum displacement on either side of the equilibrium position. So this is A1, this is the amplitude, this is A2, this is the amplitude. So this is maximum value, and in between it varies. In between, because it is total in y direction, the displacement. So displacement, it varies, and the maximum displacement here, it is A2 here. So it is amplitude, and here it is maximum displacement A1. This is again amplitude. And in between, it can say all the displacements are here in this way plotted with time. So these are the curve of displacement and time graph. So amplitude is the maximum displacement. Now, a particle moves to and fro in such a way that the acceleration of the particle is always directed towards a fixed point in its path of motion and is proportional to the displacement of the particle from a fixed point at any instant. So a particle moves to and fro in such a way that the acceleration of the particle is always directed towards a fixed point in its path of motion and proportional to the displacement of the particle from a fixed point at any instant. Now here F is proportional to displacement. So it is given, what is this? These things, F, small f, it is the acceleration of the particle. M is the, if we consider M is the mass of the particle, small x is the displacement, and capital F is the force, and capital K, that is the proportionality constant. So what in simple harmonic motion, we can say that acceleration of the particle, here it is F equal to minus KX. Now, this is the K is the displacement, KX is the displacement. Now F, capital F equal to MF, we know total force equal to M into F. So in place of F, I'm writing minus KX. So start from here. We know the force equal to mass into acceleration. We all know these things. Force equal to mass into acceleration. So the acceleration F, it is equal to minus KX. So putting the value, so M into minus KX. So that thing I'm writing as equal to minus mu x. So what is mu? Mu equal to m into k. So m into k, that is your mu. So ultimately force is minus mu x. So here just write the term, that is k is here, that is proportionality constant. This is not capital K, this is small k here. So this is, you will consider this, that if acceleration equal to minus k into x. And this is equal to capital K, small k, and force equal to MF, and F equal to minus K. So putting the value, minus M K X, that is equal to minus mu into X. So what is mu? Mu equal to MK. In place of MK, I'm writing mu. So F equal to minus mu X. Okay. So any problem here? Anyone? Any problem in understanding up to this portion?
No, miss.
Then I am going to the next slide. So differential equation or equation of motion of simple harmonic motion. Now, if M be the mass of the particle executing SHM and X be its displacement at an instant from the mean position O, the force acting on the particle at point P is given by, if that is actually I coming to the equation first, then I am discussing all these things. Actually, what is what was our previous slide? Our previous slide was F equal to minus mu x. So force equal to minus mu x. Mu is the force constant. Now after that, F equal to was minus mu x. Now what is our F? F is M into F. So what is d2x by dt square? This is acceleration. Actually, if x is the displacement, then dx by dt, that is velocity. And if you take differentiation again with respect to t, that d2x by dt square, that is gives you acceleration. So our equation was F equal to minus mu x. Now F equal to what? MF. This is M and this is your F, that is acceleration. D2x by dt square is your acceleration. Now this equal to minus mu x. Now just simplifying this, d2x by dt square equal to minus mu by M into x. So this is your equation now. So d2x by dt square equal to minus mu by M into x. Now I'm writing this as d2x by dt square equal to minus omega square x. So what is your omega square? It is written omega square equal to mu by M. So in place of omega square, I am writing mu by M. So d2x by dt square equal to minus omega square into x. So this is our equation where omega square equal to mu by M. Now changing the side, I'm just putting this right hand term to the left hand side and writing d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. So this is our differential equation for simple harmonic motion. So for this, from where I have started, force equal to mass into acceleration, then this acceleration is minus kx, and putting this value, then I have written f equal to minus mu into x. Then after that, f equal to minus mu x, now in place of capital F, that is force, I have written mass into acceleration, that is d2x by dt square. Now just simplifying or writing in this way, that d2x by dt square equal to minus mu by m into x, then in place of mu by m, I have written omega square. So omega square equal to mu by m, and here d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. So this is the differential equation for simple harmonic motion. And what is omega here? Omega is mu by m. Omega is natural angular frequency. This is the natural angular frequency. So this is very important. That is the differential equation for simple harmonic motion is d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. What is x? X is the displacement. Okay. Any problem here? Any student?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
So here you will note down this in your copy, that the question is given. Write down the differential equation for simple harmonic motion. If it is given, only write down, then you have to write it and you have to explain the terms. And here it is coming that from equation that F equal to capital F, that is force, equal to minus mu into x. And from here we are getting this. Now, this is the equation, so we can solve this equation actually. As it is the equation, so we can solve this equation and we can find out the solution of this equation. And solution is x. So this is the differential equation. And what is the solution of this differential equation? The solution is x. So we will now, what is our task? We will solve this equation and we will find out the value of x. And actually the value of x, you know, that is the equation of SHM. Do you know x equal to what for SHM?
A cos omega t plus phi naught.
Okay. Or a sine, you can write. Okay.
Yes,
in terms of sine or cos. So that thing I will prove now. How the x is a sine or a cos, whatever you are saying, that for that value, how it is coming from that differential equation, that I'm going to explain. Now, solution of the differential equation. So that was the differential equation for SHM already given. Now, there is one method, that is trial solution method. Trial solution method means what? That I am taking one solution. I don't know what will be it exact form, but let I am taking the solution. That means x. X is the solution of the said differential equation. And I am taking the solution, let x equal to what? A0 e to the power pt. In this way, I'm writing. I don't know what is p, what is a0, nothing I know. But I'm taking the, let it is the solution. So I'm taking the trial solution as x equal to a0 e to the power pt. Now, if it is the solution, then it will satisfy that differential equation. So d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. This is the differential equation. Now, if x is the solution of the differential equation, then if I put the values, finding out from this value of x, that will satisfy that equation. So what is in that equation? In that equation, it is d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. So we know the value of x now. Now, if we find out d2x by dt square, and if we put there, we will get some values. So that I am doing. As in that differential equation, d2x by dt square is there. So I am finding out the value from x. So x is here. So find out the derivative dx by dt. Actually, this is velocity. Now, what is this? This is p. You know how to differentiate e to the power pt. A0 is constant. So p is here, and again e to the power pt. So dx by dt equal to p a0 into the power pt. I want to say to the students that revise your differentiation and integration part for this physics part for your PH 101 syllabus. That means that will help you a lot. So this is very easy differentiation, no problem for you. So dx by dt equal to p into a0 e to the power pt. Again, differentiating with respect to t. So again, I'm getting p square. Here it is p. So differentiating with respect to t. So it is p square a0 e to the power pt. Now what I'm doing, just putting the value. Just putting the value. So our equation was d2x by dt square. So d2x by dt square is what? P square a0 e to the power pt. And after that was omega square x. So x is written a0 e to the power pt. So plus omega square x. It is the value is 0. So this is our equation, that is d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0 in place of d2x by dt square. This is the value and omega square, this is the x, that is equal to 0. Then just writing in this way, taking common part, that is a0 e to the power pt, putting it outside. So p square plus omega square equal to 0. So two things may be that a0 e to the power pt may be 0 or this p square plus omega square equal to 0. So a0 e to the power pt it cannot be 0 because what? It is displacement. So if it is 0, then displacement is always 0. How the motion is simple, harmonic or anything? So it is not possible. Displacement always 0, this is not possible. So what is possible value? That is p square plus omega square equal to 0. So this into this was 0. So this term is not possible 0 as it is displacement. So the bracketed term is 0. So what is the bracketed term? That is p square plus omega square equal to 0. So from here, what I am getting, p equal to plus minus I omega. So imaginary part you are getting because p square equal to minus omega square. So from here, p equal to plus minus omega. Now, I am writing this one. X equal to what? Actually, x was a0 e to the power, just listen it very carefully. X equal to a0 e to the power pt. So now p has two values, plus omega, I omega and minus I omega. So there are two parts of p here. So this x I'm writing in two parts. One taking as p as plus I omega and another p is taking as minus I omega. So for first part, that pt e to the power pt is there, so e to the power I omega t. So here I omega t. And the second part, minus I omega into t. So e to the power pt, p is minus I omega, so e to the power minus I omega t. So the second part is e to the power minus I omega t. And the constant for the first part, I'm writing as a1. And for the second part, the constant, I'm writing as a2. Then, e to the power I omega t, how can I break it in terms of sine and cos? Anyone can say? E to the power I omega t equal to what? Or say, leave it, e to the power I omega t. Just tell me, e to the power I theta equal to what in terms of sine and cos? How I can represent this?
E to the power I sine theta.
Say again.
Cos theta plus I sine theta.
Cos theta plus I sine theta. So e to the power I theta equal to cos theta plus I sine theta. So e to the power I omega t, it is what? Cos omega t plus I sine omega t. So I have broken, it is written in the two parts, e to the power I omega t. This is equal to this part, a1 cos omega t, you can see here. And this is again written e to the power minus I omega t. It is again divided in two parts in terms of sine and cos. And combining this, and I have written in this way. That is a1 plus a2 cos omega t plus I into a1 minus a2 sine omega t. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So only I have written the part e to the power I omega t in terms of sine and cos and e to the power minus I omega t in terms of sine and cos. Then in this way it is written. So common part is cos omega t. It is taken here as it is, and inside the bracket a1 plus a2, and here I a1 minus a2 sine omega t. So this is our displacement. So now what I'm doing, I'm writing a1 plus a2 as what? C1. So this is some constant, a1 plus a2. I'm writing it as C1. And what is our C2? I a1 minus a2. So this is total one, another constant I'm taking. So you can write in this way. This is mathematically, you also know that if they are C1 plus D1 two constants, you are writing C1 plus D1 equal to say E, some constant, another constant. So I'm writing in this way, a1 plus a2 constant, it is written as C1, and I into a1 minus a2 constant, this total as written as C2. So this equation reduces as x equal to C1 cos omega t plus C2 sin omega t. So in this place C1 and in this place C2. So it is written like this. So displacement equal to C1 cos omega t plus C2 sin omega t. Now what I'm doing? C1 equal to A sine phi, I'm writing. And C2 equal to A cos phi. So what is, if I divide this two, that A sine phi divided by A cos phi, so it remains as tan phi and C1 by C2. So tan phi is C1 by C2. So from here you can find out the value of phi, that is equal to tan inverse C1 by C2. And what is your A? Just square it. A square sine square phi plus a square cos square phi equal to what? C1 square plus C2 square. So a square sine square phi plus a square cos square phi. So sine square phi plus cos square phi, you all know that is 1. So in this side, it is a square equal to what? C1 square plus C2 square. So E is root over C1 square plus C2 square. So we have the value of A and phi now.
Ma'am.
Now, say.
Hi.
What is phi? Where is phi?
Yes.
I am writing now C1 constant as A sine phi. I'm just considering, put assumption, C1 equal to A sine phi and C2 equal to A cos phi. Okay. Now divide A sine phi by A cos phi. What remains?
Tan phi.
A sine phi, tan phi. So this side you have divided, then this side also you have to divide C1 by C2.
Yes.
Okay. So tan phi equal to what? C1 by C2.
C2.
So tan phi is C1 by C2. Then phi equal to what? Tan inverse C1 by
C2.
C2. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now I'm just putting my assumption here. That is, I have already said that is C1 equal to A sine phi. I have written, say, X equal to A sine phi, X equal to, C1 is A sine phi. So A sine phi cos omega t from this equation, X equal to C1 cos omega t plus C2 sine omega t. Here I'm writing C1 as A sine phi and C2 as A cos phi. So just writing X equal to A sine phi, cos omega t, so this cos omega t, this is cos omega t, this is cos omega t. This is C1, the value is A sine phi, plus C2. C2 means A cos phi, I have written A cos phi, then sine omega t, here sine omega t. So ultimately this is the expression of our displacement. So X equal to what? X equal to A sine phi cos omega t plus A cos phi sine omega t. So what is the expression? Sine A plus B. So sine X equal to A sine omega t plus phi, is it? So this is the equation of simple harmonic motion. X equal to A sine omega t plus phi, where we know the phi is this and A is this. Now you can also write in terms of cos. So if you put phi equal to theta plus pi by 2, so if you put here phi equal to theta plus pi by 2, then what you will get? X equal to A cos omega t plus theta. So in this way, this is also the equation of simple harmonic motion. So actually this is the solution. Our differential equation for simple harmonic motion was d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. Now solving that differential equation, we have the solution. And what is our solution? That is known to you all, that is x equal to a sine omega t plus phi. If phi equal to 0, we can write simply x equal to a sine omega t. So this is the solution of the differential equation of simple harmonic motion. Okay, so this is the solution. So today I am not discussing much things here today. So this is the up to this I am discussing today. So again, I will take the next part I will discuss. So next part I am saying just what I will discuss in my next class, that is the velocity, acceleration of the particle executing SHM, then some examples. This is the kinetic energy, potential energy graphs, some illustrations of simple harmonic motion, so time period of oscillation, then oscillation of liquid in U-tube, then this is the oscillation of liquid in U-tube, this is the oscillation in LC circuit. These are the examples of simple harmonic motion. So these topics I will discuss in my next class. As today's the first class, so I'm not discussing much things today, and only 6 minutes remaining. So I am just now students, I want to say something to you all. So this is my first class, and I have just discussed the simple harmonic motion, about simple harmonic motion and about differential equation and its solution. If anyone has any problem, then ask. Whenever you are not understanding, then ask me. Don't hesitate. Okay, because you have to cooperate with me, because this is not your offline class, it is online class. In offline I can contact you, you are here present in front of me, I can say that I can check you are writing or not. So this is not comparable actually, offline and online classes. But no problem is here, you know, due to COVID situation, so you have to all cooperate. Whatever I am saying, that read it. If I give you the assignments, if I give you the questions, then just complete your task, day to day task. Don't delay the task. Complete your task on time. Now, students, you are here for 1 to 45 total roll numbers. How many students are from Asansol? Abhijit Shaw. You are from where?
I'm from Bazar side.
Okay. From which school you are?
I'm Banpur Riverside School.
Banpur Riverside School. Very good. And next one, anyone remaining?
Ma'am, Agnishwar Mukherjee, and I am from Newtown.
Okay. And you are again from Banpur Riverside School, is
yes.
it?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is nearer to you. Okay.